Hello friends, welcome to another Monday Daily Toast, and no, we are not toasting a Wario game today. I just felt like wearing the Wario hat, because I was already wearing a yellow shirt, and I thought, the yellow hat looks pretty good with the yellow shirt, right? I'm all about style, aren't I? Toast. But I am wearing a Mario shirt, check it out, see?
Yoshi!
Okay, so, magical. So, it's been a rough weekend. I actually caught a cold, and still a little bit sick, but mostly my kids are still sick, so, you know, things have been kind of crazy hectic. I've been trying to get my new episode of Yay Super Smash Bros. Done, but just there seems like there's always something to hold me back. So, toasters, hoping to get that up by Christmas. Rabbits. Anyway, have you guys seen these yet? The World of Nintendo action figures? Holy cranberries. So, I thought these were cool back when they came out a couple months ago, right? And, you know, been collecting them, because that's sort of what I do, is just buy Mario toys. Look at these. They're so cool. Here's the Wario one. They got bending elbows and everything, and ball joint arms. I mean, you have some pretty good action figures. But I'm so excited because I found out there's going to be a Wave 2, a Wave 3, and a Wave 4. So we're going to get figures like, you know, Luigi, Diddy Kong, Samus, Ganondorf, Fox McCloud. Do you believe that? We're actually going to get a legit Fox McCloud action figure. That is incredible. Very much looking forward to that. So yeah, these World Nintendo action figures just might be what you're looking for in your stocking come, what, Thursday's Christmas? Holy cranberries, that is soon. Hey! Maybe that's why I ended up wearing the Wario hat, because I'd be showing off my Wario action figure. I gotta open my Link still. Here's Link. And there's also Mario, Yoshi, Donkey Kong, and Bowser. I have Mario, and I have Donkey Kong, and I have Yoshi. I don't have Bowser yet. He's like impossible to find. I wish I saw him in the store once, and I wish I'd bought him, and I didn't, so toast. I will have a lifetime of regret because of that. But apparently they might do Dry Bowser. Won't that be cool if they do Dry Bowser? We'll see. And also, as we talked about, I think it was on Friday. Watcha. Okay, so I actually went and I bought Sonic Boom, Shattered Crystal. Do you know how big of a jerk I feel like to buy myself a present, like, right before Christmas? So that's how much I care about you guys, right? Because you were requesting this game, so give me some time to play this game, and then I could give you somewhat of an accurate toast. Speaking of which, you know, I really like to get a good amount of playing time in a game before I toast it. Sonic Boom, Shattered Crystal aside, there seems to be a very specific category of games that you guys have been requesting a lot, right? Here's Paper Mario, The Thousand Year Door, Super Mario RPG, and then of course the Mario and Luigi RPG series, right? Except for this one, Mario and Luigi Superstar Saga. I don't think anyone has requested this one yet, which is too bad because this is the one I've been playing the most. What I was trying to get into here is these games, these Mario and Luigi RPG games, and Paper Mario, Thousand Year Door, and Super Mario RPG, these are all games that I have not completed. I have not beaten them, so I don't have that full knowledge of what these games contain. I was not purposely avoiding these games throughout the year when toasting, but that is something that maybe I just was going towards other games that I knew more about because I like to look like a know-it-all when I talk about these games. But these are the ones that you want the most, right? So, out of all of these, there's been a few Dream Team requests, a lot of Partners in Time requests, but I think the game that was requested the most is Bowser's Inside Story. So, let's toast this one today, right? Mario & Luigi Bowser's Inside Story. So all four of these Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga games, sorry, all four of these Mario & Luigi RPG games, I've played all four of them. I've started all four of them. I've gotten a ways into them somewhat, sort of, but I have not beaten a single one of them. And I'm openly admitting that. Not gonna lie, I've not beaten a single one of these Mario & Luigi games. But out of all four of them so far, this is the one that I have liked the most. Here's what I like about it. I like playing as Bowser. He is a fun character to play as. I mean, he's tough, he's powerful, He's mean, which makes him really entertaining, and I like that he talks, right? Mario and Luigi, they just speak gibberish, right? And they never have any kind of dialogue. Bowser, on the other hand, he is the third part, you know, the third playable character in this, and he does talk, and he is hilarious, he is fun, he is great, and you just feel really cool playing as Bowser. Mario and Luigi, on the other hand, they kind of take a backseat to Bowser, in which I'm not crazy about the Mario and Luigi gameplay of this one, because Mario and Luigi, they're more in the, they're inside, physically inside Bowser, right? And so, sometimes if Bowser needs some, like, physical, like, I don't know, adrenaline or something, Mario and Luigi have to run around inside of him and hit certain things or do certain missions to enhance Bowser or stuff like that. I don't know. It just seems like Mario and Luigi are such a side note. Like, I feel like Bowser totally steals the show of this game. I think one part of it is really clever and really funny. Bowser has this attack where he inhales his enemies, and the enemy goes down inside his body, and then you have to fight them as Mario and Luigi, and then they escape out, and you can keep fighting them as Bowser. I think that is just hilarious. That is very funny and well done. But something about these games, like, I always get into them, but they just don't draw me in enough to where I want to have that desire to complete them all the way through, like most games do, and it might be because there's so much more story-driven, so much text, I don't know, I guess I'm just more into action games, where you just sit down and start playing, you know, like New Super Mario Brothers and Smash Brothers and stuff like that. Those games are good, but that's one thing that's interesting, how these games are all called Mario and Luigi. They're not called Mario Brothers, so kudos to Luigi for getting his name in the title, when usually he's just the one who puts the brother into the Mario Brothers, so yay that. Some of Bowser's special attacks are pretty cool, where, like, he throws his minions, like, he'll get a bunch of Goombas, and he'll throw them, and then you could shoot fire at them, set them on fire as they run at your enemies. He shows how much he really cares about his minions, right, Toast? you know what's weird is one of Bowser's attacks is he throws a bunch of Shy Guy minions, right? And the Shy Guys and Bowser has always been kind of an interesting relationship to me that I've always kind of wondered about, because think about it, Shy Guys, they were first introduced as enemies in Subcon in Super Mario Bros. 2, aka Doki Doki Panic, right? So, yeah, Bowser was not the villain in that one. So then when we get back to Mario 3 and Mario World, Shy Guys are, like, nowhere to be found. We don't see them again in an adventure until Yoshi's Island, Super Mario World 2. And we know there the main boss is Baby Bowser. So maybe, this is just me speculating here, maybe the Shy Guys are loyal to Bowser, right? When he was a baby, the Shy Guys were his main minions, and, you know, they were loyal to him. They were all he had, perhaps. Well, except for all his other minions in the Yoshi's Island games. But, like, Shy Guys are the main ones. And it wasn't until Bowser was an adult and he tried, you know, started trying to conquer the Mushroom Kingdom that he gained the loyalty of the Goombas. We do know, this is canon, that the Goombas are traitors to the Mushroom Kingdom, right? So maybe Bowser earned the loyalty of the Goombas and started using them as his main minions. Perhaps maybe he doesn't care about the Goombas as much, and that's why he sends them out, you know, front and center into battle. You know, you always face a Goomba as the first villain, first minion, you know, in every Mario game almost. So maybe since the Shy Guys have been loyal to Bowser longer, maybe he keeps them back a little more. Because in, like, Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga, you fight Shy Guys in Bowser's castle and everything. So we do know that Bowser does have some kind of authority over Shy Guys, right? From Yoshi's Island and from that. So, yeah, that's something there. Bowser and Shy Guys, it's interesting. Because when you think about the main Mario, you know, lackeys that you fight, you think Koopa Troopas, you think Goombas, you think, you know, Lakitus, Spinies, Buzzy Beetles, Cheep Cheeps, Bloopers, Hammer Bros, Bob-Ombs, like, those are, like, the main ones you think of. You don't ever really categorize Shy Guys as those. Today they're thought of more as Yoshi villains than really Mario villains. But, yeah, Shy Guys are there, and they are part of Bowser's kingdom, the Koopa Kingdom, Shy Guys. Yeah, that's something interesting. So yeah, so Bowser's Inside Story, I don't know how it ends. Don't spoil it for me. I'm going to finish the game someday. But I like it. And out of the four Mario & Luigi games, this one I have to say is my favorite. Of course, I don't have a whole lot to back up that statement with since I have not completed any of the four games. So thank you for watching Daily Toast, and tune in tomorrow as we continue to toast games, and send me more requests in the comments. And yeah, toast. Thanks for watching.